The campus is comprised of approximately 60 buildings here all in one campus. It's a big metropolitan area network. There's about 10,000 folks connected to the network on a daily basis. We have doctors asking for tablet PCs so they can walk around, see patients, take notes, to doctors in the trauma room with handheld cameras that they want on wireless so that 50 or 60 of them are looking at patients, trauma patients, and being able to give diagnosis and not have 60 folks in a patient room. Technology has to work, and it has to be fast. And we cannot afford cold channel interference, which is a big problem with traditional wireless. You have to design your wireless based on that criteria. Channel 1, 6, and 11, and then the channels repeat, and they cannot see each other. If they see each other, there'll be a disconnect, and the user goes offline for seconds, minute, whatever the recalculation time is. Multiply that times hundreds or thousands of folks, and it's a huge problem. You need an army of staff to maintain that environment. And it's exponential. The more APs or more wireless you have, the worse the problem gets. We looked at Cisco as Cisco Wireless as a solution for the medical center. And we started deploying and got up to about 150 access points from Cisco. And just realized that we cannot manage that environment. It was out of control for us. The Cisco product just didn't scale. Cisco said they could mirror Meru, or they can act like Meru, they can work like Meru. And their idea of that was an auto-tuning feature on the controller that would tune the radios of all the different APs and kind of theoretically manage that environment, and that doesn't work. We had to survey three buildings at a cost of about $150,000. In the Meru environment, none of that's needed. You just put the AP wherever you'd like to place it, same channel as the rest of your deployment, and we just bought it. We bought a pilot, which was 25 access points in the controller. We tried to break it for 3 months, and we threw all the basic apps you can think of were not really a problem. Our second order was 100, and then it went up to 500, and it's just the actual engineers that maintain the product is very small. And they're maintaining 25 controllers and over 3,000 access points for Meru. There's really no competition for the way Meru does wireless. In the Meru environment, there's no co-channel interference, which means I don't need to design a 1611 deployment. I could pick one channel and deploy the entire network on the same channel. You just put the AP up in the MAC address and go to the controller and just activate it. It's very simple. The mobile device always sees the same MAC address, so it never thinks or feels that it's being handed off from one access point to the other. It's completely seamless to the device. The doctor can roam anywhere on campus, anywhere across 2.5 million square feet of campus space. We even have wireless deployed in the external areas using directional antennas that are facing outwards from the buildings, and they're covering all the external areas of the building. So as a doctor's walking from one building to the other, hallways, tunnels, cafeterias, restaurants, they're actually still in communications with the university practice. And in a seamless fashion, as they're walking from one building to the other, their call is completely crystal clear and uninterrupted because of Meru's virtual cell technology. The Meru product, in the 5 years that we've had the product at the medical center, has been completely reliable. We haven't had any problems with the technology or the equipment or the access points. Everything has worked perfectly. There is, like I said before, there is no product that in the same space as Meru, using the same technology. They truly are unique in the way they use the technology.